This is the eighth lecture on the series of the presence of black people in the Bible. In this lecture, we intend to provide more evidence on the ethnology of Adam and Eve. We shall provide evidence that indicates that this pair was of African soil. In the seventh lecture, we pointed out the location of the Garden of Eden. We also said that the original name of Africa was Al-Kibulan. This word means the Garden of Eden, or the original home of all mankind. The garden was located in the region known as Northeast Africa, presently referred to as the Middle East. It is important to understand that the whole of Africa was called Eden. Eden was not just a single country or region, but was the whole continent of Africa. It was in the continent of Africa where God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our similitude." God formed man using the soil of Africa, and man became a living soul. It is also in this continent that Adam and Eve had the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day on the soil of Africa. This lecture, therefore, confirms that Adam and Eve were dark-skinned peasants, and so were their descendants. The following artifacts you are looking at are of Adam and Eve from the Catacombs of Russia. Louis Farrakhan says, open quote, "You study biology and you learn Mendel's law. You know that the dark skin is dominant and the light skin is recessive. You know that dark eyes are dominant and the light eyes are recessive. And you teach that you get recessive from the dominant, but you can't get the dominant from the recessive. So two white people can only produce white. You can never produce yellow. It is just not in your genetic makeup to do that. It is a biological, mathematical impossibility. But a black man can produce some jet black people, an albino with blonde hair and light eyes, showing you that in us is the whole human family. You are black because you are not cursed. You are black because you are the original life in the universe." Close quote. Christian art and white exegetes went completely out of kilter by depicting God, Adam and Eve, and angels as white. These pictures and artifacts of a white God have programmed minds of millions of people to pray to a European white God who has never existed. Let us watch this video from the National Geographic, which confirms that Adam and his descendants were dark-skinned peasants.
Jefferson may look European, but his Y chromosome tells a different story. It shows that what we look like may not really tell us where we come from. And it raises a question mark over the traditional image of Adam. For centuries, artists have depicted him like this, like a European. For many of us, this is Adam. Michelangelo's famous painting in the Vatican Sistine Chapel. He looks like a beautiful Italian who spends a lot of time in the gym. Did the common ancestor of all men really look like this? the story of Jefferson suggests he could have looked very different. Finally, Wells comes face to face with the man he's been searching for. A new portrait of the common ancestor of every man today. Adam. Without a skull, we can't know for sure what Adam looked like. But a combination of genetic evidence, Bender's forensic skills, and cutting-edge computer software suggest he looks something like this. Thousands of years after the Bible, and hundreds of years after Michelangelo, we have a whole new face for Adam.
I like the expression. He's got a very forceful look.
He's intent on something, maybe taking over the world. You begin to get perhaps an insight into why these guys won out and why this guy's our ancestor.
Here are some of the pictures that we will talk about in our next lecture. Commemorative artifacts of black persons on the coins of different countries. The original Buddha was a black man of African origin. German composer Wolfgang Mozart was black. Once more, as I close, the Bible was written by black people.